Boy, video game. I wonder what this one is.
Video game controversies. You know them. You tolerate them, I guess. Sometimes they're really bad. Really stupid. But today we are going to go through a list of actually important video game controversies. This is not my usual style, but since I'm like kind of tired, I guess this is what we're doing before I go on my little break. First controversial video game, Death Race, pulled off the store shelves because you had to run over gremlins. Well, got every because people got really upset because you heard this little gravestone came up. It's ridiculous. There's no way this got banned. Anyway, on to the next one. Night Trap.
I don't believe what I just saw. Those bloodsuckers just got Lisa, and you had a chance to save her.
Trap, Sega CD version. Was that a Toys R Us, which I think is funny for like a team game, and Night Trap was cited as a shameful, ultra-violent, sick and disgusting, encouraging an effort to tap and kill women, which I think is funny. You know why? I don't think the situation they thought it was is funny, but I think the fact that they got it so wrong because of the fact that you're like supposed to stop them from doing it. You're supposed to save them from killing people. Like, come on. Anyway.
I know what you're all here for.
Mortal Kombat is the first video game to feature lifelike realistic violence. Pioneer for the video game franchise, introducing the whatever, man. You know. Together with Night Trap and Doom, it is the focus of the 1993 congressional hearings. Blah, blah, blah. Mortal Kombat stayed in stores. Hooray! A big one here. Jack Thompson files the first video game lawsuit. A large number of lawsuits claiming video games are responsible for violence by teens. The lawsuit is filed on behalf of the parents of three children killed in the Heath High School shooting in 1997. Investigating show that the perpetrator had regularly played various computer games: Doom, Quake, Castle, Wolfenstein, Redneck, Rampage, Nightmare Creatures, Mech Warrior, Resident Evil.
He did a lot of bad stuff.
Thompson is permanently disbarred by the Florida Supreme Court for inappropriate conduct, including making false statements, tribunals, and disparaging of humiliating litigants. Okay. And then this guy, in 2001, is like, there's a little thing between media and violence. Perhaps? I don't know, man. More GTA controversy here. I say more because that's in the thing I'm reading, but like, we haven't talked about Grand Theft Auto, basically the most controversial series. But a lot of two Tennessee families actually. Anyway, as I was saying, two Tennessee families sued the maker of GTA and other video game companies after a shooting in which the killer claimed he was imitating GTA 3. Oh my god. I'm not laughing at the situation. It's terrible. A shooting? That's bad. But imagine playing GTA 3 and going, man, I should do that. I just think that's ridiculous. another thing. Minnesota video game ban enjoined. Yes, amazing. The 8th Circuit Court of Appeal strikes down a Minnesota law that bars anyone under 17 from buying or renting a video game rated mature or adults only. The same court enjoins, whatever that means, ordinance in 2003 that bars the sale of or rental of video games with violence content, blah, 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 nobody really cares. Honestly, there's a lot of correlation. For some people, think there's a lot of correlation for some reason. Mass shootings and GTA. So many people are like, hooray! It's GTA! You know what I should do? Go shoot some kids, man! Like, come on, this is ridiculous. I've played Doom. I love Doom. Doom is my favorite franchise, but I've never thought of brutally ripping somebody in half and done it. But, like, I just think this is ridiculous. Mortal Kombat and everything, yeah, yeah, blah, blah. Doom, Phasmophobia, Phantasmagoria. I just think it's kind of crazy, you know? It's ridiculous. It makes no sense. Let's look at some more, shall we? Oh, you know what we just love talking about over here when it comes to controversy? Which I've never talked about. Pokemon! Yeah! Like, you know, a lot of weird designs, like Jinx, that was not very good. I'm pretty sure you already know about that. I don't really feel like talking about that. Satanic themes. And also freaking, Jesus Christ. Freaking the 9/11 episode, as people call it. It's in the freaking, tentacool. Knocks down a building. Oh, no. 9/11. I mean, I get it. I can't say I don't get it. I just think it's kind of weird. Wolfenstein in 3D. Now, why was that under controversy, you may ask? Perhaps. Nazi symbolism. Oh my god, I laughed so stupid. Wolfenstein 3D. Spinal boss. Adolf Hitler. Oh my god. I can see why it has some controversy. Oh my god. That's terrible. Dance Dance Revolution has controversy? For what? Let's see. Pills and I'm Alive and alcoholic drinks appearing in Club Tropical. Okay, that's some small stuff. Conker's Bad Fur Day. We don't need to talk about that one. Let's go through two more normal games. Let's go through two because I just found a really funny one. Just because by the name. Okay. After these two, we'll go through a recent one. But let's talk about JFK Reloaded. What is JFK Reloaded, you may ask? Well, if you don't know, the player is given the role of the assassinator of President John F. Kennedy. And Ted Kennedy, the senator, was described it as despicable. As it is despicable. That's terrible. There's controversy around Mario Party 8, guys. Oh my god, Luigi said fuck. We're done for. But no, Kamek uses the phrase, turn the train to spastic, make this ticket magic. Which in the UK, the word spastic is offensive. Led to the recall of a game, and later release of the word erratic. Oh my goodness, we cannot have the word spastic in there. I'm not trying to... 2020s. Why does Animal Crossing have controversy? Animal Crossing New Horizons. The game was pulled from Chinese online digital sales as it allowed creators to create their own displays in the game, some of which were to support the 2019-20 Hong Kong protest. Oh, that's not a thing to ban a game over. Hogwarts Legacy. Oh, yeah! J.K. Rowling! They did some bad things! You could say they did some bad things because they did. What's another game that's not going so well in the current day? Pokemon Go. For inspiring criminals to commit robberies using the augmented reality feature. Oh my god, is that a Pikachu?
Oh yeah, you know what we do with that Pikachu? We go rob the bank.
Like, what? South Park, the stick of truth, that's reasonable. Oh my god, the Stanley Parable. Oh no! Dude! Can I talk? I'm gonna talk about it. I'm gonna say something. But oh my god! In the Stanley Parable, there was controversy. I should not be laughing. This is terrible. An in-game instructional video called Choice contained an image of a white man lighting a black child on fire. Oh my god! Stanley, what are you- Stanley, no! Stanley, what are you doing? Oh my god, no. That is bad. One more, let's go. Little Big Planet. It is a song. Okay, well, I thought it'd be funny, like, Little Big Planet showed his little Wang planet.